Okay, Harinder is that, you know, that all the license and work on IPR, patents, trademarks, registrations, guidance, advocacy, consultancy. He works with a firm, they are both partners, I believe. Correct me wherever I'm wrong. Aparna is a time member, she's been with us for more than a year and has been helping our startups also. So, Aparna, over to you. Can we know the first three important things for a startup? If I have a startup, I have to start. What are the three things I need to worry about?
First thing is that what you want, you need to identify that. That your goal should be set for a startup. The second is that you should be sure of your resources, that what you have right now and slowly take a step towards it. And a third important fact is if you can, find a partner. Very important.
Whether you find a partner or you go to do it all alone. Totally useful. So sometimes most of the phones we have seen they break because partners are not compatible. Sometimes.
So it's like both sides. If you get one good, otherwise the other. But it's very important for a startup to initiate. To initiate, you should have a proper streamline. Like this is what I want to do and that's how I want to go about it.
You see, Anshubhi is in partnerships and a right guy to speak on.
I would want to, you know, I can fully support you on the issue of having a partner. You always need a, say, sounding board.
Yeah.
Because as you go up the ladder in any corporate world or your own company, it's a very lonely world out there.
Yeah.
So if you have, whether you are celebrating success or you are drowning in sorrow for any failure, you need somebody who's there who would understand.
Right.
And that's going to be a partner, whether it's your life partner or your corporate partner. Here, there's one other thing, you know, normally any entrepreneur who starts is the last things on his mind are the cash book, the balance sheet, the filing legal hassles, copyright, patents.
That's what I was like on the second point, money. You should know where your resources are, how much you can.
No, so normally an entrepreneur who's starting doesn't know. He's not even aware. The main thing is, which everybody says, you know, first customer. How to get your first customer? So it's always sales and not even marketing. It's always sales and then execution.
Yeah.
It's chicken and egg story. You get the order, you have to make sure by all means 24/7 how to fulfill it and just deliver it. So and this is a cycle where some people break that and set up the support organization very well, and for some the cycle continues and everything else is at all. You have a visiting CA who comes twice a month and does all the paperwork. You have you never have a lawyer, but somebody sometimes you have. Then you have a consultant who's an ESIC consultant or a PF, he also comes into picture because somebody has come and laid in your office. You know, where is your PF statement? What is PF? You know, so things like this. So besides, you know, sales and execution is his bread burner. That he comes to know by hit and trial or by willful, spending of time or by guidance or by whatever. But all these support issues, which I believe are extremely important in India, also because when you set up a company, say in US, it's so simple that you say in here you can do it, and it's very well listed that what is to be done daily, what is done quarterly, what is yearly to fulfill all the legal hassles. Here, fortunately or unfortunately, they are not there. So,
once you are in a problem, you consult the lawyer.
Yeah.
What to do? It's not a preventive thing, it's a curative aspect.
So, here, when you continue your discussion, when you say that you should know what your roles are, like I said, sales and execution, most of the answers won't you know. So, professionals like you, how to ensure or what mechanism should be there from the entire ecosystem or what is it that is there, that this should be given some importance right from the beginning so that when the time comes, it can be done in a very streamlined way.
Yeah.
I don't know how.
Definitely by, you know, consulting people who have this expertise.
Yeah.
And people like us, that what is the best for you, whether you want to like to start off only, whether proprietor, what needle entity you should go on for, how much can you do? It's a proprietorship, a partnership, a LLP, a company, whatever options are. First of all, initially you should make sure that you understand all of it.
Yeah.
And then go. Because at times what happens is that you're not even aware, like, and the number of people, what all laws you have to apply,
and the problems you might face when you are going to execute.
Because it looks very nice when somebody says that, you know, this entrepreneur is not even technically qualified, he doesn't have an MBA, he's 12th pass, or he's a simple BA, he's started an IT company. So I fortunately am an MCA, I did my MBA finance. I knew about many things when I went into the entrepreneurship journey. These were implicit in me, that what is happening, how is it happening. But most of these, you know, guys, they learn when something hits them. So what is it, that checklist, that if somebody comes to Sumit, that I am going to start on my own and I want, this is my plan, that my market is going to be Australia and I have the best talent. So Sumit should tell him, this is the checklist. Do you have all this in place? Or do you have plans and next 1 year this will be there? Okay. If there's any doubt, contact Aparna or Harina. So what
well,
is
that's
that?
Right, I think that that thing is missing.
That is very much required.
Yeah, absolutely.
This is very much required.
So let us take an example of Mayuri. She and Deepa. They are planning a startup.
Very good.
They made a name. Decided on a name, but that was taken by somebody else also. They had a conflict, they gave it up, right? They trademarked it, they also trademarked it. But they thought, okay, we give it. They came up with another name. Now, they are studying. But what are the rules for them?
What we feel is that initially, we don't have so much money that we can consult a lawyer. We can go to them, consult them and ask for what are the issues and things like that. So, what are the things that we can do initially? We are an email management
startup.
It's a service. So, first, you must have identified your market.
I would say, first of all, your partners, first document should be a partnership deal. Even if it is your friend. To be like as lawyers, you always a little bit negative. To be honest, you say you see document only if a conflict comes. Before that, nobody sees any document. But to have a partnership deal, to have it in writing, this could be the percentage of investment. This could be our profit whenever they come. It's not an issue that they have. To the market and amount that okay, this could be a salary, this could be the expenses. However, it happens over a period of years, it's fine. A partnership deal is essential if you want start. Have a place of like if have things on the like all everything written, whether it's your correspondence, whether it's your accounts, there should be no ambiguity. Because what we see is that even if you have to go to a CA later on and file a return and things like that, he would also ask you what were the investments or what were the expenses. Have things documented. Put it on paper, put it on mails, wherever it is, it should be there. So that you know there's no that's not a gray area. That I had 1 lakh rupees, where did I spend, and you, where did you spend? I don't know. That should never be a gray area when you start. Like any, at any point of time.
It should be clear between you.
Always. It should be clear. This would be the thing. The other thing would be that, like, slowly, like, have a partnership, make a current account, have a PAN card, have these things. Basic things to start off with. Have everything. Like,
so the first step could be current account.
After the partnership deal, you would go and apply for a PAN card and then get a PAN
card. PAN card will come from for the company.
Yeah, in a partnership firm, you can have a PAN card.
But individual proprietorship of personal card.
Yeah, that works.
That
works. Yeah, as a proprietor, that works. You will, as a proprietorship firm, there is no separate entity other than a proprietorship. In a partnership firm, you separate. Have a PAN card. Have all your payments in the above PAN account. Whatever expenses you take it out from this. Like put it on for that yeah, taken out from PAN card, you need a PAN card. If you think it is about 10 lakhs, 9.5 lakhs, you need a service tax. So this is like these are small things, but slowly and gradually if it is increasing, you need to go, if you are 8 lakhs, 8 and a half lakhs or something, you go apply for that. It's done online for you. PAN card these days, you can just apply online and you just have to get a piece of aluminum piece and that's it, and you get your PAN. So things are being easy, it is getting better with the legal and accounting system. It will take time, but it's not that bad.
I think there is, yeah.
Yes.
One question for the sake of all of us. A new form of company was introduced much later in India, because normally as partners or as shareholders of a company, whenever you take a loan, you have to sign some kind of a guarantee. And that kind of puts you liable for unlimited liability. So LLPs was introduced much later, which was there already in the Western world, I believe, in some form or the other. So for the sake of her and me, can you highlight that what is the benefit of an LLP and what are the drawbacks?
So let us talk about partnerships and LLPs.
Yes, partnership versus an LLP.
Partnership, to be honest with you, LLP is a simplified form of a private limited company. If you are talking about the compliances, you have almost a similar number of compliances what you have to do in a private limited company. A limited liability partnership has to file all the returns, it has to maintain its books of accounts, the meetings have to be run, the minutes have to be filed, the way you do it in a private limited company. The advantages, like a partnership firm is like what we have in India, is partnership is a separate entity, but the liability is unlimited. If you just have a simple partnership, most of, like how many ever partners are there, their liability is unlimited to the extent of any liability which arises to the company. Whatever happens, their liability is unlimited, their earnings are also unlimited. In a limited liability, you can limit your liability to the extent of your ownership in a company. So LLP is basically helping you to limit your liability, still having the benefits of the partnership. So that is the main thing in the LLP and the company.
May I, in my layman terms, yes. May I say that if me and her form an LLP with equal stake,
yes.
So say if it is a 1 crore capital,
yes.
so our liability is limited to 33.3
yes.
lakhs.
Yes. Right.
So whatever may happen, the maximum I need pay out or whatever is limited to that fact.
Yes,
yeah. So let's say the company owes 10 lakh rupees to M, right? Yes. You are only liable to pay 3 lakh something.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes. That's the limit.
But in a partnership, it's 50.
Partnership, the entire liability is on both of you.
Again, it depends on you. The agreement is to make.
But
it could be any percentage.
But that amount has to be covered by both of you.
Yeah.
In a partnership.
If one guy is, you know, bhaag gaya, chala gaya, so the other one has to pay.
Yeah, that's unlimited.
I don't know.
Yeah, I see.
You are more in the, into it, you know. What challenges do you face?
I'm
what sort of cases come?
I'm dealing with technical stuff,
purely
technical. Whatever legal terms that was open, whatever technical terms I get. Of course, we are doing techno legal work. Basic purpose why you started this call. I'm a technical person, I have completed engineering post graduation. And after that, I was selected for scholarship scheme. So I will be paid in
scale. Yeah, there's another thing I would like to ask. Do you think that in US, right? US, Europe, London, East countries, even Singapore, let's not go very far. Singapore, where we लोग लॉयर्स से ज़्यादा डिपेंड नहीं करते यार दे जस्ट दे आर अवेयर ऑनलाइन है दतिया इफ दे आर स्टक समवेयर दे गो एंड टेक अ सर्विस डू यू थिंक इट्स मिसिंग इन इंडिया वी कैन डू इट आवरसेल्फ आल्सो मेनी थिंग्स
वी कैन हैव वी
देयर इज अ ब्यूरो
साइड नो वी कैन नॉट
नो इट्स ऑल बेटर
बिकॉज़ इफ देयर आर समथिंग वी डिजर्व समवेयर
या
वी नेवर बेटर समवेयर
व्हाई यस
व्हाई
ऑनलाइन व्हाट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट that material is not available in India. That is totally exhaustive. Here, if you see something online, major things will be missing out of
it. It is not a full information.
No.
What happens
it is rather misleading.
In a legal partnership, something, you cannot say yes, you have to put it on naturally. So you have to be, you have to consult the legal person so that that can go wrong in a defensive manner. That whatever I am stating, is it correct? If I am signing something other...
So it is basically better to have a shield and the right...
Yes, yes.
See, for example, let me
introduce
you.
Yeah, please.
You go to a provident fund office, you ask them the legalities, they will never give you a single one. They'll ask you, meet me after office hours. There they are professional charges and they'll give you a. But in the office, which they are supposed to do, they will not give you.
The forms are also objected
when you file
it
with
them.
Yes.
Oh,
yes. This is what happened. You're right, absolutely correct. And the Provident Fund department is the worst in this when you start a business.
So, for people who can afford to pay higher on their business than yourself, they can have a minimum salary which is much above what is legally required, and the person can opt not to pay the Provident Fund. But I think even if you do not pay the Provident Fund, you still have to file a return.
You have to file.
Which of course goes as zero, but then you still have to file a return.
So let us talk about the writership, somebody starting. What are the three things you need to do before he starts or while he starts?
Legal question.
Okay, legal. Okay, Aparna for you. And then he should forget it for 2-3 hours. Business ki taraf dhyan de, isko badhane ke liye.
At the proprietorship, if you just talk about legal, you have to see the two three things. What is it? If you're doing a loan, you have to pay your website, so you don't have to do anything.
So let's say somebody is doing
what exactly is it?
Let's say event management proprietor.
Yeah.
What is name? So talking about your journey, when did you guys meet and how did you start?
How did you become part of it?
We had one common family friend. Okay. So we went through that
person
and then we realized eventually, once we met in some person, then we met in one seminar, we realized we had so many things in common. He being an illegal and I being a patent agent, we thought we could become partners because both of us were starting to think, starting like we should start on our own. We were thinking at that time. We just started discussing and met again, then we became friends.
Then slowly we started. So it's been how long? Since 2008
we started.
It will
be 5 years.
So is your relationship a limited liability partnership or a partnership?
It's unlimited. It's just a partnership.
It's just a partnership.
Unlimited liability. And unlimited profit.
Great.
Great. So 5 years, how has been the graph?
Slowly.
Okay.
It's been we also started the way she was asking questions, then we were at the same level one day. That day we also fought our day.
Yeah, had a good journey discussing our people in the cafe, having the discussion on
so
what
all
I
goes
need to
on that
be.
Day.
Yeah,
and
so now when we turn back and take a look at the life how much we
have. Did you acquire just like it for our knowledge? Did you put it on? What were the initial two main challenges?
Finding the first
One window job. It's a one window job.
Why is it guys in tires?